crowd. There's always something happening and it's usually quite loud. Our mum, she's so house proud. Nothing ever slows her down and a mess is not allowed. Our house, in the middle of our street. Our house, in the middle of our...
Mark was so embarrassed to show his face on camera, I'm taking a spot today.
Tomorrow, any student who brings in 3 canned food items or $1 will be able to wear a hat tomorrow. On Thursday and Friday, any student who brings in 3 canned food items or $1 can play cornhole during their lunch period.
Also, if you would like to karaoke next week, you must sign up at lunch today. After you are signed up, your name, picture, and song title will be placed with an envelope in the cafeteria. The students with the most money in their envelopes by the end of the week will get to sing next week.
Hat day's tomorrow.
Oh. Really?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh. There will be a pep assembly this Friday, February 7th, from 1:40 to 2:30. We will be following an early release schedule that day, so plan to head down to the gymnasium after the end of 7th period. Please make sure to sit in your appropriate sections, sophomores, juniors, and seniors, as your classes will be competing against each other.
Big Blue wrestlers enter Lakota East Saturday for a competitive and tough GMC tournament. The Blue put 6 wrestlers on the podium, scoring ahead of Middletown, Coleraine, Princeton, and Oak Hills. Edward Collins was a GMC finalist, edging number 2 seeded Lakota East in the semifinals in an exciting overtime victory.
The Blue also won 5 of 7 consolation semifinal matches, advancing David Pitts, Daniel Ramirez, Abel Ramirez, Brandon McKinney, and Joey Reese to the podium. The wrestling team hosts Talawanda and Winton Woods this Thursday for its only home dual match of the season for senior night. Wrestling starts at 5:30. Make plans to come out and support the Blue.
Everyone should come out to the first Big Blue Gymnastics home meet in the HHS gym this Sunday, February 9th, starting at 1:30. Gymnasts from several local schools, including Baden and Lakota, will be competing, as well as us celebrating our senior night. We also need volunteers to flash scores and keep time, so contact Coach Reimer in room 167 if you're interested in getting service hours. Come out and support your Big Blue gymnasts.
If you like to run or walk, you can participate in the Shamrock Shuffle 5K or 10K run walk at the Square at Union Center on Saturday, March 8th. For each person that signs up, JKB will earn $10. 25 team members will give JKB $250, and 100 team members will raise $1,000 for this leadership organization. To sign up, go to www.shamrockshuffle.com and select the J. Kyle Braid Foundation of Butler County.
Jewett's Dewitt's Club's next excursion will be to Newport Aquarium on President's Day, Monday, February 17th. The group rate is $17 per person. If you're interested in going, stop by 212 and sign up by February 12th, as reservations must be made in advance.
The following seniors will be signing to colleges during advisory tomorrow in the auditorium. Alex Anderson, Quentin Bailey, Tyler Denton, Ryan Kennedy, Preston McIntosh, and Devin Pankey.
Good job, guys. Student Council members in the Collaboration Pod, Special Events Pod, and School Spirit Pod will meet today after school in Mrs. McGuffey's room, 717, to create posters and finalize plans for the pep rally.
All student council members need to get the after-prom survey on Mrs. McGuffey's door and return them to her by the end of the school day, Wednesday.
Attention, witches and wizards! Harry Potter Club will be meeting this Friday after school. If we have enough members attend, we will be splitting apart into houses for some competitive fun.
And that concludes your morning announcements.
I don't care. Today's hat day.
Crowd, there's always something happening, and it's usually